We have some practical crash courses from companies and brands who are sharing some exclusive insights with us right from the trenches. So first up, we have Neil Pandya, head of media from L'Oreal.
Hi, Neil.
Ipshita Chaudhary from Signify, which was previously Philips Lighting.
Hi, Ipshita.
And, they are going to talk to us about and share insights on the shifting investments in marketing, product and tech that are helping businesses to actually fast track their recovery in the new world. And to moderate this session, I'd like to welcome Sanjay Tripathi, co-founder and CEO at Jillio Labs. Hi, Sanjay. A very warm welcome to all of
Hi.
You. And I will leave it to you, Sanjay, now.
Hi. So I think Anand started it very well. How the COVID-19, post-COVID-19, how the world is changing. So we know the consumers are no longer spending. They're not going out. You know, most of the places we are unable to even send the supplies. So it's a massive disruption in terms of the how the products and the brands we used to market and what is currently happening in our world. I think I've got two great panelists along with me. So I'll start with Neil. Neil, you know, they say during depression time, lipstick sales actually goes up, you know, because people want to look more presentable. Now with a mask in your face, it's very, very difficult to even forget about lipstick sales. You know, lipstick is not required. So how the marketing priorities in this thing is changing when people are not so confident about their life, they are so uncertain. How you and your team are really guiding through this time in terms of navigating during this time in your marketing spend?
Okay. Firstly, hi. Hello to everyone. Hi, Ipshita. Hi, Sanjay. Hello to whoever's watching us. And then on a lighter note, I'm so happy this is the first ad tech session which has started on time. Shiny is going to kill me for that. But thanks to tech, we are starting and ending sessions on time. Coming to your question, Sanjay, I believe marketing is the most difficult job right now. A marketeer currently has to balance the demand of business, consumer, and there is a new habit which is coming up. There is a new environment which is coming up, which is worrisome, emotional. And to top it off, there's no playbook for marketers for such situation. So whatever he's doing is testing and learning in this criteria. And all of this test and learns are basis reprioritizing its own product mix, its content strategy, its communication. So marketer is changing his priorities across levels. So to give you an example of beauty industry, marketers in beauty industries are changing their content strategy. Prior to COVID, most of them were busy creating thematics or commercials on those lines. Post-COVID, all of them have started focusing on education content because, consumers are demanding about how to do hair color at home and DIY tips and others. So that's how people are, marketers are also moving and creating content as education in that form. Marketers at the same time, I believe, Sanjay, are also changing the communication strategy. Take for an example, my communication prior to COVID was a slapstick humor. I wouldn't want to take that communication on air right now because the environment is very emotional. People are in a worrisome time. So I need to reprioritize what communication I'll take it on air. And to give you a context on how marketers are reprioritizing the product mix, as you mentioned earlier too, beauty industry is divided largely into four categories: hair care, hair color, skin care, makeup. And to draw attention, if you see last 2 months, the advertising spends in this beauty industry are focused only on two categories, which is hair care and skin care. So which is a clear indication how every marketer in this category are reprioritizing into essentials in beauty. So the essential in beauty here are about shampoos or are about hair care, hair conditioners or skincare and face washes and all this. So I believe as a combination, all of these marketeers in our industry are trying to reprioritize the current, understand the current situation and reprioritize the marketing mix. That's how I believe it's where we're going.
Thanks, Neil. That's a great input in terms of beauty industry. Ipshita, there is no help at home most of the places because they're not allowed in your housing societies. So you're mostly alone. So the kind of appliances people are now looking for is very different. So in your industry, how you are looking at this change in terms of the things people are going through post-COVID and how you are reprioritizing your objectives?
So, you know, ours is a little bit, you know, in the middle of essential and non-essential, though from a government regulation guideline perspective, lighting per se doesn't feature as an essential. But, you know, it is one of those products. If a light goes bust in your house, you will end up replacing it no matter what. So, two parts to that question. So, one is, of course, there is reprioritization at three levels from our perspective. One is, of course, at a very fundamental product level. Then there is a reprioritization at a GTM channel level. And, of course, at the level of the consumer engagement and outreach. Now, for example, to give you the product example, now something that we had to think on our feet and come up in the last 2 months. Now, UVC-based lamps. You know, that technology always existed, right? And we as Philips Lighting and Signify now, we had been supplying and we had been manufacturing that and giving it to, you know, various water purifiers, air purifiers. And it's one technology that does kill bacteria and viruses. Now, we knew that was never a priority for us from a product perspective, from a marketing perspective. But suddenly in the last 2 months, we've actually come up with UVC lamp-based products, which are now getting launched in the market. So globally, we've already launched. So you have sanitizers on one hand, and you have this product on one hand, which will soon be launching in India as well, which can sanitize your surfaces through ultraviolet radiation. So, you know, whether it's your laptop, your books, your courier deliveries, any surface can be actually sanitized using this light technology. So that's a reprioritization from a product perspective. Secondly, from a channel perspective, of course, we know that we have, we are a very traditional retail led, organization. We have face-to-face interaction with consumers in our stores. That, of course, is not happening. And there is a fear. There is a fear of hygiene and apprehension all around. So from a channel perspective, a lot of our focus is now going on e-commerce, which we always said we will do. But now there is actually no option. One has to reprioritize and make sure that products are available where consumers are, which is in e-commerce and on digital. And thirdly, from an engagement consumer perspective, obviously awareness-led campaigns, mass campaigns are on hold. And that's a reality for many categories. So what are we focusing on? We're focusing more on CRM, getting back to influencers, working with architects, interior designers, who are a big part of our value chain, trying to upskill them, ensure an atmosphere of ease among them. So that's how, you know, I think life has completely changed across all aspects of marketing.
I think great point, Ipsita. Coming back to you, Neil, I think a lot of brands are no longer spending money. I think a lot of studies, you know, are going on saying only except Amul, nobody has really upped the spend. You know, they're again, because of Brahma and Mahabharata, it is all digital. So, Neil, what is happening in your media spend? You know, what are the kind of places you're maximizing or holding the spend, or where you're spending today?
Correct and wrong. I mean, there's a yes and no answer to your question, to be very honest. Why yes? You know, I believe, you know, take for an example, any crisis, the Great Recession of 2008 or SARS, anywhere globally, the first thing which marketers or a brand will do will reduce the cost, right? Dandani or I, obviously you'd want to reduce the cost. But there are enough studies also happening in the times that whoever marketers or brands have done smart investment into these crisis times have seen a larger long-term benefits compared to the ones who have gone silent. So, it's obvious that marketers are reallocating their spends wherever there is a better, higher yield or a better ROI. So that's the mota reality of where we are. What do I see in our industry and most of the other industries also is that a lot of brands are shifting, reallocating their budgets towards digital. Now, this is not new news. I mean, pre-COVID also, most of us all were shifting to digital for its capabilities of programmatics, technology, dynamic, creative, and a lot of other things. And at the same time, there are lot of MMMs. I think I'm sure Ipsita also would have seen, and you also would have come across. A lot of MMS, cross medias, CMMs are indicating that digital is far efficient and effective in normal situation, in pandemic situation. So point number one, a lot of them are allocating digital in these difficult times. I think Ipsita or someone else earlier mentioned that in these difficult times, we have also observed globally and in India, e-commerce is something which is picking up as a business platform. So again, to draw a direct relation of digital spend to e-commerce and converging the final funnel where the consumer is closing its conversions. That's where digital is again having a higher edge compared to other platforms. You know, but if I have to put a devil's advocate or put a devil's hat, there are brands who are seeing that television bahut sasta mil raha hai. You know, this is the times where television is available at 50% or half of the rates compared to pre-COVID. So why not do a multimedia strategy? And multimedia definitely works better than a single media, as from a lot of studies we have seen. So to cut the story short, in media right now, I feel that brands are focusing and reallocating their budgets where they are seeing a higher ROI, effectiveness and efficiency. And that's how they are moving together.
Okay. So I think, as Neil said, you know, it is like in a more like still you do a comprehensive marketing in terms of looking at where you can get the best value. So Ipsita, are you seeing like take is started playing a major role in your kind of marketing? Because, you know, now that e-commerce has become a major parameter in terms of your business and, you know, looking at new products, which are never sold in India. So how is take playing an important part in your marketing today?
Tech is definitely playing a very, very important role, and it's all across. I think gone are the days when we would say digital first strategies. I think now these are times where there are digital only strategies, and that's the reality. So to give a very simple example in how we have adapted. Now, in a traditional, retail-oriented organization as ours, and the sales system is very traditional, it's very conventional, right? So you have your sales teams who are so used to going face-to-face into the market, working with distributors, partners, taking orders. Now, a simple thing like that, which impacts the entire sales, cycle for us, is impacted. We cannot have now, because of whatever norms that we have, we cannot have our sales teams out in the market to go out and do what they were doing 2 months ago. So how we're using tech here, of course, we are relying a lot on mobile apps. And because, you know, everybody may not have a laptop, but everybody has a smartphone. So through apps, we are enabling our sales teams to ensure that, you know, we can monitor them. We know where they are because we can use geolocation. We know who they are meeting, what kind of norms of social distancing, et cetera, there, whether it's a green zone, orange zone. So I think those things are slowly and gradually helping the business pick up, because eventually if the business doesn't pick up, no matter what we say in terms of marketing or spends or advertising, none of that actually holds true, because at the end of the day, consumers are in a space where discretionary spends are going to be pulled back. And that's the reality. So, business needs to pick up. And so tech is enabling our sales team, for example. Tech is enabling our influencers, for example. We are doing webinars with our influencers day in and day out with our sales teams, with, as I mentioned, with architects, electricians, whom we work very closely. We need to upskill them. We need to allay their fears. So the channel has to come back to its full steam. So I think tech is getting used pretty much all the time and in every facet of our business, and not just marketing.
Neil, in your business, is a face-to-face is a pretty important role, because, you know, someone chooses anything on beauty, like they want to see, they want to touch, feel. That's why, you know, I think every store has someone as a L'Oreal girl, you know, who's there to assist the customers and all. So in this situation, she talked about more about how tech is helping the distribution side of the leg. Can you tell me how you're doing for a B2C side in terms of reaching up to customer, how you're using MarTech to make that happen, real-time marketing, data-driven marketing?
I believe that, you know, in these times of lockdowns, tech has been boon to most of the industries in general also, and to specific to our industry also. I take for an example of all of us. I would love to attend multiple conferences, but I never attended them, and webinars have become so important to upskill. So I choose what I want to listen and I upskill myself accordingly. So tech as a boon is really important in general for most of the categories. Talking to our category now, we believe that beauty and tech are a perfect match. Beauty is all about, visuals. It's all about socially shareable. Whereas on the other side, tech is all about digital with smartphones, who are also visually appealing and shareable. So we believe beauty and tech is a perfect match. And the future of beauty is beauty tech. And we are the pioneers. We want to be the pioneers in this particular beauty tech as an industry. And we have been into this journey pre-COVID itself. But during COVID, this tech has enabled us to accelerate this COVID journey, this path in which we are moving into. To give an example, what we do at L'Oreal in terms of tech is about, we define it into digital factories. Our digital factories are layered into two to three things, important things. The first one is all about service factories. Here we are talking about virtual try-ons. You rightly mentioned that, you know, we used to go on the shop and purchase it, but this virtual, in this lockdown scenario, people can't move out. So it's really important that if Ipshita wants to buy a lipstick, she need to see how it looks on it. So virtual try-ons are playing a great role as a service factory. On the other end is another section of content factories. Lockdown is there, social distancing is there. We are not able to shoot new content. And in this situation, dynamic creative optimization technologies are really a boon as a form of a technology to create our assets, which we can use it online and target contextually. And lastly, all of us are aware it's about data factories. When I talk about data factories, it's all about programmatic, CDPs, any other things which we are managing. And all of this is helping us not only bring in media efficiencies, but also to bring in larger revenues because we are understanding our consumers far better. So a combination of all of these things, I feel, Sanjay, it's a boon for as a tech which is helping us into the social lockdown and social distancing and lockdown.
Okay, my last question to both of you, I think you can answer one by one, in the sense, the consumer, we take around 21 days to change any behavior. We say habits get formed, you know, in 21 days. Already we are more than 70 days in lockdown. I don't know, like, you know, Mumbai looks like another 2 months in lockdown. So what do you think will consumers will change for good in terms of, or marketing will really look at that, change customer behavior at least next 2 to 3 years in terms of that will not going to change back, or a marketing need to really look back that side using tech? So what are the two or three things which comes to your mind in terms of which will be a permanent change rather than a temporary change, both from your customer perspective and marketing perspective?
Ipshita, you can go ahead.
Okay. So I think, a couple of things that come to my mind, and I think some of it in terms of consumer trend we had already seen coming. So, you know, this whole consumer trend around wellness, well-being, health, these were trends which were on the anvil. And we, you know, every category has its own take around that. I think that is surely now not just a trend, it's a reality. And I think brands, organizations will have to find their angle to it, because that's one big trend that will exist in the market from a consumer point of view. So how can we adapt our propositions, our messaging around it, if at all amenable to our category and industry? I think that's one big trend, and that's one big change that I see going forward brands and organizations undertaking. Second, I definitely believe, and it's a big learning more from a human perspective, is that when we look back even at ourselves as consumers in the last 2 months, what was the most important thing for us? The most important thing or need for us was accessibility, something that I can access immediately, my essentials. And at that point in time, your local kirana or the guy who could source things for you ended up being the most important guy in your life. So I think accessibility, brands will have to win back the confidence, the trust. Consumers are at their vulnerable most right now. So winning back trust, winning back that confidence is extremely important, even for bigger brands. And I think that's where being accessible wherever your consumer wants you, whether it's information or whether it's a product. If you're there, I think you will be able to win back the trust and the confidence. So I think winning that back will be a big thing for marketers. And lastly, I think brands with a purpose. Never ever before, I think that has been important. Everybody, we have been talking about it, that, you know, purpose-led marketing and all brands standing for something. I think that will become even more critical going forward. Brands have to have a solid purpose behind their marketing.
Nice point, Ipshita. Purpose is definitely, this is a time when, you know, you should really think about for the brand. Neil, any last point?
Yeah, very well said, Ipshita. I mean, you know, I earlier mentioned also there's no playbook for learnings right now. So whatever we have learned is based on what others are doing or what ourselves have done. I have tried and created 4 C's in COVID times, you know. These 4 C's are largely, the first C is context. It's a global pandemic, but the impact is local. So don't blindly follow what global people are doing. It might do your decision making locally. So set the context right, I feel. Second C, I feel, is constant review. I mean, the only thing which is changing right now, constant right now, is the change. So things are changing hourly, weekly. So it's really important for marketers to ensure that they are constantly reviewing all of their media mix, marketing mix, product mix, as we mentioned earlier. The third C is creative consideration. there will be a new normal post COVID. So we need to ensure all our prior creatives are, will they work in the future or not? So identify those situation, analyze those situation, and take a creative consideration for the next coming months. And the last thing, which I believe is really important, is to contribute. It's the time where customer is your extended family. Don't leave them alone. Don't go silent. Contribute in any way or form which you're gonna, which you can do it. And this will, this is not short term. This is long term benefits. You're gonna gain a loyal consumer. So I believe these are the four C's. I feel as a learning which you can take it forward from COVID times.
Thank you, Ipsita. Thank you, Neil. I think this is a great point. I think we have to close our session because the RL Saini will become angry and they'll ping me. I think this is a time which we need, brand need to really rethink how to really reposition themselves, as you rightly said, 4 C's, context, content, see with a purpose, and more importantly, use take digital wherever possible to really reach closer to customer and see what best you can help to contribute and support to customer. Thank you so much. Thank you, Saini. Thank you, Neil. Thank you, Ipsita, for that.
For one question. We have a question from Avinash Tharani who says, from the tech stack, does L'Oreal or Signify use a CIP, a customer intelligence platform? Are you using DMPs? How much importance are you really giving to first party data? Either of you, both of you.
Ipsita.
So yeah, there are platforms that one is using, and it is important. I mean, that's the backbone of the business. And it just becomes more real time now. And, real time business decisions are taken on the basis of that data. So, yeah, extremely important on all facets of the business.
Exactly. And no different answer. I think it's important.
Yeah.
First party data is the most relevant important data, which we are looking forward to in these times and in future also. So I think it's the same answer what Ipsita mentioned.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I think there are more questions for you. So if you want to log into that Q&A panel and answer them, I'll be great. So
sure.
Thank you so much. This was a great session. And I think we learned a lot that we can actually go back and implement today itself. Right?
Thanks.
So thank you.
Thank you so much.
And Sanjay, that was a very, very insightful session.
Thanks, Shaini. Thank you. Thanks. Bye.
Bye.